All right, real quickly here while we're designing this fun Ecovillage scenario, the 100 village version. Now, we're talking delivery now, delivery, not birthing babies, but yeah, delivery of trucks to town. Okay, so let's say you have this 100. You know, sporadically throughout an area. The best, easiest way I can fathom to make this inexpensive is to have started 100, the 100 village, and whatever's in that 100 village that's to go to, let's say, to San Francisco. They take their items from their truck and they go to Village 99. Okay, now at Village 99, they swap. There's a point right there where they take out a trolley, one trolley, and it says to San Francisco. And all of those items get put into the 99 village van. Okay. And on that same little van, on the other side, then there would be inner village deliveries system. So let's say you want the wool now to finally go to Village 12. Okay, so that goes on the other side of the van. So one side would be for external products that go to the city. And this other side goes to, so it would be like two cages on rolls, okay? And they roll off, literally, one truck to another. Now, so from 99, you take the new goods, you take it from 99 and you take them to 98 village. And 98 village truck gets its things rolled on. Its empty truck gets rolled on the fresh things that came all the way from Village 100 already. And if there was anything that was sent to them specifically, they get it delivered. So, and you just keep this going on and on and on. I know this is a slow way to go, but it's cheap and it's effective. And you probably only have to drive 5 miles maximum. That is the cool part of it. 5 miles to and 5 miles of there to and fro. So, yeah. So let's keep in mind the greatness of that, so you don't have to be on the road driving, making 50 or 100 village journeys here, there, and everywhere. Instead, you have these cute little eco-village produce, whatever they are having that they're bringing in extra, is being filtered and sent van to van to van to van. And it's a van switch system with rolls, rolling from one to the other. Okay, and that's it. A very simple system, and it will take maybe a day to do that process. So let's say you had lettuce in the truck number 100. It is going to be out there in the heat, so that type of thing is a little annoying. So we would have to think of maybe kind of how to keep it cool, how to keep certain things cool. But yeah, so that's my delivery van system for the most inexpensive way to run Ecovillages while also garnering some income out of that city, that great, great big city, because who the heck wants to drive it every day and it's costly and all of that. So you can get those products that are your products into the city, and yet, like, especially if they're food products, And yet you don't have to drive it every day, so that saves the travel of 100 vehicles going that distance again and again and again. So anyway, I think in that last video of blog at the bottom of it, if you check in the information, I wrote a whole bunch of data about the duties of the board, the directors, whatever, what they have to do. And remember, they're not going to be directors that are out there in space living in the ritzy hotels, you know, some extravaganza, they're going to be the directors that live with us, and they're going to live on the properties. So this is not going to be like a, oh, well, see your money gone type of system. We're going to see them handle the money right there in front of us. You understand? So we're going to be a little bit more guarded that way. So there won't really be that easy cheat, run away. All the board of directors ran away with the cash from the poor Ecovillage people. So that won't be a phenomenon. You know, we'll have like five, let's say maybe one or two from each village that are really like the heads, you know, that are up there, and maybe you don't really get a super CEO or something in your village, but maybe a couple villages down there's a super CEO there. Ooh, you know, so you can still have that corporate structure to a certain degree, but yeah, that's kind of interesting. So what I'm dealing with right now with my brain is I'm thinking about water. And getting water, you can always, I mentioned, all, you know, ponds and pools and all this, but above ground pools are great. There's nothing wrong with them as a storage device. There's nothing wrong with them. And that would be something else. You know, you're pulling all of these things together, people may even have some, you know, they may even have one in their back garden. And so they'll just, you know, that would be something else. You know, bring your above ground pool. That would be wonderful. And that would be something that we can use as a delivery device. Now, if we can raise it, we can raise that, make it above ground, obviously, above the village a little bit, like a water tank, a regular water tank, and just feed trickle it a little bit at a time. Then we're okay, because we have the down gravitational pressure, and that can just off to all kinds of people's houses, whatever, and you can use the flat tube rolling all the way it goes. So it can be done. You can feed to each house inexpensively, but for right now I was actually just not even going that route and just having it at the main community center area. Okay, so I think that's it. I think that's all I can handle today.